Welcome to the What's New presentation of MDA 8.5.2. My name is Matthias Gekeler. I am at ETAS, the product manager for MDA. And I want to show you in the next 50 minutes the following features. In case you want to access a topic directly, you can use the jump marks listed below the video. I start with the assignment of measure file extensions to MDA 8. When installing MDA 8.5.2, automatically the file extensions MF4, MDF and .dat will be assigned to the MDA application. So when double-clicking such a file in Windows Explorer, MDA will be opened and the file gets loaded. Afterwards, you can continue in MDA as usual, for example, displaying a track in a GPS map. If MDA is already open and the active configuration contains exactly one file, a replacement will happen by the newly double-clicked measure file. You can see this in my example by the changed track. To add a second file to an active configuration, just use drag and drop. In case the active configuration includes two or more files, upon double-clicking, a dialog appears. There you can decide either to add the new file or to replace one of the other measure files. Two enhancements were implemented for the GPS map instrument. Additionally to the track, the GPS map instrument supports now to display event signals along the track. Just drag and drop the desired event signal, like a comment entered during the recording, into the map view. The event marker gets the same color as the track, so that in case of several tracks, you can distinguish the corresponding events by its color. To differentiate the different event types like comments, calibration activities or a pause, the color for the flash inside the event marker is used. In the tooltip for each event, the textual information is given. Removing an event signal again from the map view can be done in the Configuration Manager. The second change for the GPS map instrument is an improved plausibility check for the signals added to the map view. This prevents that signals which do not represent GPS coordinates show nonsense tracks or even block the application. The next topic is about copy and paste between configurations. To reuse layers or instruments, these can be copied and pasted in the Configuration Manager, even across different configurations. When pasting such objects, MDA performs two checks. First, whether all of the copied signals are referring to the same measure file. And second, whether the target configuration contains just one measure file. If so, MDA changes the reference of the copied and pasted signals to the measure file available in the target configuration. Consequently, for such one-to-one cases, the no-match situation can be prevented usually. Except a pasted signal is ambiguous or is missing in the target measure file, like the pause event in my example. Next, I'm going to show you the enhancements done for the properties window. With MDA 8.5.1, the basic properties windows for all instruments was introduced, as shown here for the GPS map instrument. For all other instruments, their specific instrument properties are included now into the properties window. Always the properties of the active instrument are shown. Changes are applied immediately. And depending on the property, a change might also be used as default for a newly created instrument of the same type. For each property, a tooltip provides more details. By introducing the instrument-specific properties window, icons for less frequently used properties were removed from the instrument toolbar of the oscilloscope and the scatter plot, like the background color icon or the icon for the grid visibility. This improves the clarity of the toolbar. Also integrated in the properties window is now the former axis settings dialog. Axis properties can be opened from the axis context menu directly. Also for the axis properties, any change will be applied immediately. This happens from the table to the actual axis, and also vice versa when changing axis in the view. Also for the oscilloscope, some improvements were realized. For the selection wheel introduced with MDA 8.5.1, now tooltips are available. These describe the function of the currently selected segment. Additionally, the icon was reworked, which stands for the option to take over the axis formatting from the source oscilloscope. For any signal shown in a Boolean strip, the decimals are now completely suppressed. If a signal was assigned erroneously to a Boolean strip, the original number of decimals is shown again when moving the signal back into an analog strip. Moreover, now the oscilloscope also shows the signal curves of signals having a non-monotonous conversion formula. For performance reasons, MDA's oscilloscope is using reduced index data of the measure file. But the index of the measure file is based on implementation data. If the conversion formula is not monotonous, then the min and the max values of the index data are not necessarily the min and the max values of the physical data. Accordingly, MDA cannot use the file index for such signals, and consequently, the performance for drawing the curves of such signals is just on the somehow slower level as for signals from a not indexed measure file. Now some smaller enhancements for different functionalities follow. To prevent unintended deletion of layers, the X icon for this operation is now shown for the active layer only. Additionally, this saves some space for the layer tab, so more layer tabs are now visible simultaneously. The behavior for the signal search fields in MDA was optimized. Not just the last used search string is persisted, but also the search mode. By deleting the wildcard at the very left of the search string, the search mode changes from contains to starts with, and vice versa when entering the wildcard again. Moreover, this behavior was harmonized in the insert window and in the search fields of the variable explorer and the configuration manager. Since MDA 8.5.1, it is possible to define the number of bits used for hexadecimal or binary data representation of so-called measure culls. These are recorded as float values by INCA. With MDA 8.5.2, for any signal having data type float, the user can now define the number of bits used for hex or bin representation. Per signal, the last defined value is persisted and proposed as default. Editing of measure file metadata of MDF files was introduced with MDA 8.5.1. Now with MDA 8.5.2, also the so-called default comment can be modified. The default comment is created automatically at the end of a recording by INCA, but it might contain sensitive information which you want to remove. But please consider that the original meta information remains in the file and can be read in an editor tool. This is the background of the shown warning. To remove the original file meta information permanently, you can use MDA's export functionality. Finally, I can present a new functionality which allows to merge measure files. The use case behind could be like this. On a test trip, you have recorded subsequently several separate measure files. But for the analysis, you want to have these files combined into one. I tried to reproduce such a situation. You can see here from five separate files the same signal. Using the time offset for files, I can shift the signals in such a manner that it looks as being one. But when zooming in, the separate characters of the files can still be seen. By means of the command line tool MDF combine exe, the separate measure files and consequently their signals can be joined. I start with the simple case of two measure files. These are indicated by -s as sources and the destination file by -d. All files must have the same file format. Let's see the result. The corresponding but separate signals were combined. However, when combining the files, their actual start times were taken into account. And this results in a time range of almost 25 minutes without samples. My second example will demonstrate the combination of all 5 files and additionally the reduction of the gaps to a minimum. MDF Combine tool offers the needed options, namely the mode reduce, which requires to define also a threshold for a gap and the size of the desired gap. In my example, any gap which is longer than 1 nanoseconds shall be reduced to 0 nanoseconds. Maybe you have noticed that I listed the source files in an arbitrary order. MDF Combine will sort the files chronologically and will also check whether files are overlapping time-wise. If this is the case, MDF Combine is not able to combine the measure files. My example files are not overlapping, so I get one measure file in which for each signal group one combined and chronologically sorted signal is contained. The individual signals must be identical in their metadata, like device, raster, data type, conversion formula, and so on. In addition to the combined signals, the new measure file includes a signal named file. As it can be seen in the table instrument, the file signal states the source file name as well as start and end time of the original files in the combined measure file. In this list, all enhancements of MDA 8.5.2 are summarized. Details for each topic can be found in the What's New slide set. It and further information material can be opened directly from MDA's help ribbon. I hope you find this presentation useful. Thank you for watching it and your interest in MDA 8. Goodbye.